And the Lord spake unto Moses, saying, command the children of Israel that they bring unto thee pure oil, olive, beaten for the light, to cause the lamps to burn continually. Without the veil of the testimony in the tabernacle of the congregation, shall Aaron order it from the evening unto the morning before the Lord continually. It shall be a statute forever in your generations. He shall order the lamps upon the pure candlestick before the Lord continually. And thou shalt take fine flour and bake 12 cakes thereof. 2/10 deals shall be in one cake, and thou shalt set them in 2 rows, 6 on a row, upon the pure table before the Lord. And thou shalt put pure frankincense upon each row, that it may be on the bread for a memorial, even an offering made by fire unto the Lord. Every Sabbath he shall set it in order before the Lord continually, being taken from the children of Israel by an everlasting covenant. And it shall be Aaron's and his sons, and they shall eat it in the holy place, for it is holy unto him of the offerings of the Lord made by fire of a perpetual statute. And the son of an Israelitish woman, whose father was an Egyptian, went out among the children of Israel, and this son of the Israelitish woman and a man of Israel strove together in the camp. And the Israelitish woman's son blasphemed the name of the Lord and cursed. And they brought him unto Moses, and his mother's name was Shelomith, the daughter of Debri of the tribe of Dan. And they put him in war that the mind of the Lord might be showed them. I read this. And the Lord spake unto Moses in Mount Sinai, saying, speak unto the children of Israel, and say unto them, when ye come into the land which I give you, then shall the land keep a Sabbath unto the Lord. 6 years thou shalt sow thy field, and 6 years thou shalt prune thy vineyard, and gather in the fruit thereof. But in the 7th year shall be a Sabbath of rest unto the land, a Sabbath for the Lord. Thou shalt neither sow thy field nor prune thy vineyard. That which groweth of its own accord of thy harvest thou shalt not reap, neither gather the grapes of thy vine undressed. For it is a year of rest unto the land, and the Sabbath of the land shall be meat for you, for thee, and for thy servant, and for thy maid, and for thy hired servant, and for thy stranger that sojourneth with thee, and for thy cattle, and for the beasts that are in thy land, shall all the increase thereof be meat. And thou shalt number 7 Sabbaths of years unto thee, 7 times 7 years. And the space of the 7 Sabbaths of years shall be unto thee 49 years. Then shalt thou cause the trumpet of the Jubilee to sound on the 10th day of the 7th month. In the day of atonement shall ye make the trumpet sound throughout all your land. And ye shall hallow the 50th year and proclaim liberty throughout all the land unto all the inhabitants thereof. It shall be a jubilee unto you, and ye shall return every man unto his possession, and ye shall return every man unto his family. A jubile shall that 50th year be unto you. Ye shall not sow, neither reap that which groweth of itself in it, nor gather the grapes in it of thy vine undressed. For it is the jubile. It shall be holy unto you. Ye shall eat the increase thereof out of the field. In the year of this jubile ye shall return every man unto his possession. And if thou sell aught unto thy neighbor, or buyest aught of thy neighbor's hand, ye shall not oppress one another. According to the number of the years after the jubile thou shalt buy of thy neighbor, and according unto the number of years of the fruits he shall sell unto thee.